out these days, like I'm walking around in a haze. I can't think straight, I can't concentrate, and I need a shave. I go to work and I look tired.
What's going on, guys? That Red WJ here. I was in the process of organizing the Jeep, and I told you guys one day I would actually lay out every single thing I carry in the Jeep daily. So this is my overlaying gear, everything I carry in the Jeep. So we'll get started the left side and move all the way down the tables. Believe it or not, most of this fits in the spare well. So, okay, first off, gotta have your koozies. I have koozies from TerraFlex, Falcon Performance Industries, and Toyo Tires. Off bug spray, can never have enough bug spray, of course. Ratchet straps, I always carry ratchet straps at all times. Never know when you need to strap something down or wrap a strap around a tire to get it back on the bead, you know, with some ether. This is actually a face mask from Rugged Ridge. Believe it or not, it's been really nice to have for dusty trails. You can put it over your face and not have to worry about getting a mouthful of dirt. So, zip ties, of course. Lighting is always important. I carry a selection of headlamps and flashlights and lights you can hang and all that. I believe I showed this, I'm not positive. This is actually a lantern. You can hang it. It's got a compass on top just in case. A head net for mosquitoes and such. Spare fuses. Bulbs. I don't remember what they're for at the moment. Nice scraper. It's always nice to have a scraper just in case. That's my selection of Allen wrenches and short extensions. Butt connectors. And we're going to move on to the tools and we'll, you know, jump back and forth here. Vice grips. Never have enough vice grips. They have helped me a billion times. Tire pressure gauge. Zippo lighter. Oil funnels. Transmission funnels. I apologize. Transmission funnels. Phillips screwdriver. These pliers. What they're called, the moment's evading me. But they have been super helpful, and you never know when you're going to... Oh, channel locks, I'm sorry. You never know you're going to need a pair of channel locks, so... wire strippers. I'm not positive what they're actually called. Pair of hemostats. I don't carry a magnet, you know, an extending magnet to get bolts, you know, if I drop one, so this has been really helpful for that, or holding something in place, pretty light. I have a selection of pliers here. Normal pliers. Flathead. I haven't used this. This is an Allen key of some sort. I've never used it. I don't know. I just carry it. A good hammer. This is a 16-ounce hammer. Could never beat it. I told you guys about this. This is a seat post off one of my old bicycles. I've used this to really tighten bolts down. It's hardened steel. So, and then I don't remember what this is called still. and then needle nose pliers, a pair of dikes. I use the dikes probably literally every day, so they're nice to have. A good set of wrenches, SAE and millimeter. They range from 8 millimeter to 18, and then I forget what the other side is, but anyway, two tape measures. My socket set, this is a Craftsman set. I got this for like $40 at Lowe's. It has been extremely helpful. I literally use it every day, like probably 10 times a day. So we're going to move back up the table for now and move to fluids. So here, this is my thermos. You can see I keep it on a carabiner so I can either strap it to my belt loop or I can hang it up in the Jeep on one of the hooks on the... in the trunk. I keep everything on carabiners so I can easily remove it, but anyway, to the fluids. Alright, so this rag, I just got this from the Mega Mopar Block Party in Reading. I posted that video. That was awesome. They had simulators and stuff like that, but anyway, So, first off, I carry multi-grade motor oil, 10W30 for the Jeep, and then transmission fluid, Castrol Transmax Max AT4, full synthetic formula for Chrysler vehicles. It works fine, and I was told it can be used. And then I also use Wolf's Head Super Duty API SN Plus motor oil, 10W30, and then power steering fluid. And then I carry a selection of rags. This is my first aid kit. I'm not going to actually lay that out because there's a billion things in there. So, good pair of winter boots. I got to get laces for this boot, but good pair of winter boots. These are rubber on the bottom, so they're pretty much like duck boots. Safety cones. I carry two small orange safety cones in case, you know, we have to pull over on the side of the road or something. They're really nice to have. Small cooler for a couple drinks and a sandwich next to me up front. If Kate's not in the Jeep with me, otherwise it's in the trunk. I got a nice canvas bag from Reaper Off-Road. I don't remember exactly where I got this bag. I believe I got it at Wildwood, New Jersey Jeep Invasion. But it's a nice canvas bag you can carry around with you. You know, if you go to an event, you know, and you pick up koozies, stickers, pens, etc., you know, you don't want to have to carry all that stuff in your pocket. So it's always nice to carry a canvas bag. And this folds up to, you know, probably a square about that big. So moving on, this little tank, I believe I've showed you guys this tank. Pretty sure I have. It's got a selection of star bits and smaller quarter-inch sockets. I'm still in the process of getting a quarter-inch driver for it. I just didn't get around to it. Universal clevis pin assortment. This is what I used for the quick disconnect sway bar links in the front. I don't use them anymore because the R keys kept falling out. I'm not exactly sure what those are called, but I call them R keys. So anyway, they kept falling out and they kept breaking. I don't know how. Don't ask. I have no idea. So now they just stay in the Jeep for whatever other purpose I can find for them. Our barbecue set. We have tongs here, spatula, a brush for cleaning the grill, long pair of forks. I believe these are skewers of some sort. I believe that's what they are. And then this is for either marshmallows or hot dogs. We've used them 100 times. This one is the same thing, and it telescopes. It so, you know, it extends pretty much. Pretty, just about as long as that one. So moving on, jumper cables. Always carry jumper cables in your vehicle. They're like 10 to 12 bucks. You know, you get really good ones, they're 20. These actually came in my BF Goodrich, or I'm sorry, my Goodyear winter safety kit, and they have performed fine. I've melted the end of this one just a little, but that's because I was cranking on a motorcycle for quite some time, and it refused to start, so, you know, you'll be all right. This is a dining set, basically. This red thing here, I have two of these. The other one's not in the Jeep at the moment, but that either goes up into a cup or a bowl, and it completely flattens, which is really nice. Forks, knives, and spoons, and then the thing they're in is two plates. And they have a pretty high brim on the side, so you can even eat soup out of them. I don't eat soup usually, but, you know, I can. This hatchet, as you can see, it has the holes in case you need to tighten bolts, you know, for whatever reason with this. 5/8, 1/2 inch, and 3/8. It's got about 5 feet of paracord wrapped around the handle. I believe I've showed you guys this already. I have yet to use this, but it's there in case I need it. I'd rather not need it and have it than need it and not have it. So this is 100 feet of paracord. Paracord will save your life if it really breaks down to it. You can use it to hang up a shelter if you get, you know, stuck in the woods somewhere. You can use it to hang your clothes up to dry, you know, if you wash them in a creek or something. So, because paracord dries out fairly quickly. I carry these carabiners. You can use these for safeties, for your trailer hitch, for your chains. You can use them to hang up whatever you want in your trunk. That's what I use them for. I use them to hang stuff in my trunk in the Jeep, but they've been extremely helpful, and they screw down and lock into place, basically. So, a good tow strap. This also came in my Goodyear safety kit. I've pulled two very stuck ZJs out with this. I told you guys that about that already. Very, very stuck ZJs, so. Pair of winter gloves. They have nice rubber grips on them. And they're fairly warm, actually. So, fold-up shovel. That's pretty self-explanatory. Folds down real nice and goes back in the spare well in the Jeep. It's got a saw on the side in case you need to cut down, you know, some branches or whatever. Ice scraper also came in the Goodyear safety kit. I carry a good tire plug kit from Slime. It has saved me 3 or 4 times already, and they work excellent, and I have rubber cement with it. So this little Pittsburgh tire inflator, it's not great. I got it for $3 from Harbor Freight. I think it was about $3. And it actually saved us the other day on Sunday when we were headed to the flea market. The trailer lost air in the left tire, and I jacked it up with my bottle jack, which we'll get to. And actually this put enough air in it to get it to a gas station to put more air in it. So that's the only reason it's staying in the Jeep. Otherwise I would throw this thing away, but it saved me once. So that's all I need to justify to keep it in the Jeep. Another tire pressure gauge from Slime. Really good tire pressure gauge. I love that thing. I'm not partial to the one with the actual gauge because they're usually never right, and these usually are. Plastic winter shovel. It's got a brush, ice scraper, and then this is the handle attachment for it. So that's pretty self-explanatory. That was the main part of the Goodyear safety kit, by the way. Nice machete. This is from Ozark Trail Outdoor. It's got a nice saw on top, and it is fairly sharp. I've used it 3 or 4 times to cut down some brush, trying to get through a trail. So this came in the kit with this paracord and this hatchet and whatever else. Oh, also, this blanket, nice fleece blanket. It's really warm. You never know, you know, if you're going to get stuck out in the cold and, you know, you can get back in the Jeep and cover up with this blanket. It's not really big, but it's enough to pretty much keep you warm. So you should definitely carry a spare blanket with you. Or, you know, if you someone's out in the snow and they get stuck, you know, and you can get them into your vehicle and try to help them warm up a little bit. Doesn't hurt to carry it because it folds up that small. And that also goes in the Goodyear safety kit that came in it, as well as the gloves and then the tow strap. Bike chain repair kit for if we're out on the trail somewhere and someone with a mountain bike has a problem with their chain or something, or if we have a problem with our bikes. We don't really ride anymore, but it's small enough to keep pretty much anywhere, so it just stays in the Jeep. I keep this next to me in the Jeep. Hangs from my four-wheel drive lever. It's all from Ozark Trail Outdoors. It's got about 5 feet of paracord, including the handle, you know, to you can hang this up. It's a real nice knife. This also came in that kit. This is the bag, the Goodyear safety kit bag. It's got a reflective triangle on it. And then on the back, it says Goodyear winter safety kit. This was $16.99, and it had all that stuff in it that I showed you guys. So that was really nice. I that's how I justified that pretty much. My buddy had told me that he didn't trust my jack stands. I put the full weight of the Jeep on these jack stands. Well, not the full weight, but the front of the Jeep on these two jack stands the other day to swap out the two front tires, and they held up fine. They're great. I even actually dropped the Jeep, you know, a little bit too fast with the jack by accident onto these, and it didn't even, you know, the jack stands didn't even know the Jeep was there. So, good bottle jack. The tools for this are under my rear passenger seat. This also goes in the spare well. I used this to jack up that trailer to put air in the tire. So that saved me. So that's why this also stays in the Jeep. And it's been helpful with the Jeep a couple times. It does take a little bit to jack up, so if you have an electric impact or, you know, just an electric drill in general, and you can fashion something to go in the hole, you can zip it up real fast and zip it down real fast. And then a nice raincoat. This is, I haven't used this yet, but I'm sure I will when winter rolls around, when it actually starts snowing. And then the last thing is, these are called tub hotels, heavy duty cleansing wipes, cleaning wipes. My buddy Jamie gave me these with the pink XJ. He had a spare tub of them, so he gave them to me. They have a citrus scent to them, but they will get your hands clean after you do a really messy job. He uses them for his road service. So they're really nice to have. I use them every other day, and you know, they've been extremely helpful. So, oh, and then the absolute last thing, I'm sorry, is good old trusty hat. My cousin actually just gave me this hat. I usually wear a blank hat with a mountain logo on it. But this says East Penn. It's from Deca. He gave it to me as a gift. So thank you. And that's pretty much it. That's going to wrap up, you know, everything I carry in the Jeep every day. There's a couple other super tiny things that don't need to be talked about. You know, it's just random carabiners and stuff like that. But yeah, that's everything I carry in the Jeep, every day. And this actually compacts down pretty well. I have my tool bag hanging off here. I forgot to show you, that most of my small hand tools go in. So that eliminates a lot. And then I pretty much manage to finesse everything else back into its spot. So that's going to wrap up this video for my overland gear. I know I'm missing some things. I still have a list to go over, but this is everything I carry at the moment. So that's going to conclude this video, and thank you for watching. Like and subscribe. Alright guys, I knew I said I was going to conclude this video, but I just want to show you what the Jeep all packed up. It took me about an hour to get everything back in. So everything you saw on them tables is now in the trunk, believe it or not. So keep everything pretty much, you know, all my lights, my thermos, and my bug net right there, cooler right there, cones right there, boots right there, lantern right there, first aid kit right there so I can get right to it if I need it, little magnetic harbor freight light, ratchet straps hanging back here, bug spray and koozies and canvas bag right here, hat hanging up there. That's one of the anchor points for a car seat for a kid. His seat's over here, so I use that one. And the piece of resistance. There's everything. That's literally just about everything that was out on them tables is now back in the stairwell. This is the probably my number one favorite thing about a WJ is this stairwell and the amount of shit you can fit in here. Pretty much everything else you saw is in here. Well, actually it is. Everything else you saw is in here. So it's tight, but it's in there. And I can access everything quickly. I know exactly where everything is. It looks like a mess, but it's pretty organized actually. So this is going to conclude this video. I'll see you guys later.